If you want Unity 3D, CryEngine, or Unreal Engine tutorials, like, comment, or subscribe for more. Welcome to another video by Jessica the Rising Phoenix Dev, and today we are going to go over some important information about why it is important to learn programming before game development, how to choose a game engine and programming language. So sit back, relax, and let's learn some important facts. Let's talk about why it is important to know programming before learning a game engine and the steps you should take before undertaking this exponentially more difficult task. Before you can pick a game engine to use, you must pick a programming language. The key part to this is when you pick the language of choice, you forget about every other programming language until you can create a non-trivial application with it and are very comfortable with the syntax of the language. What is it that I mean when I say non-trivial applications? A non-trivial application is an application that is any task that is not quick and easy to accomplish. It may mean extremely difficult and time-consuming. And to get to this level, it may take you a few years, so don't think this is going to be a very simple and quick thing that could happen in the span of a month. Many programmers don't get to this level until around 3 years after they have begun studying in earnest. The reason this is important is because once you understand the fundamentals of programming and using a single language, you only have to worry about that game engine's API and the editor. This will reduce the amount of headaches that you will have when learning that particular game engine. Another important point to note is that when learning the fundamentals of programming and a single programming language first, is that when you decide you want to learn more programming languages, you will find it is much easier to do so because the only thing you are learning at that point is that particular language's syntax. Now I know the next question will be, how do I choose the programming language I should learn? The answer is simple, really. What is it you want to do? If you want to learn game development and the tools that most major companies utilize, then the three very obvious choices are CryEngine, Unity, and Unreal Engine. They all have pros and cons associated with them, and each have learning curves in different aspects of using them. The next question I often see is, which game engine and programming language is the best to learn and use? The answer again is very easy. There is no best. They all can achieve the same effects depending on the skills of you and or your team. There is no such thing as the best programming language, as they all are designed to fill a need and a role. On the flip side, the programming languages that are mainly used in game development are Assembly, C, Lua, and C++. C# is a relative newcomer to the party. As stated before, each programming language fills a very specific niche in the world of game development, so don't get caught up in thinking you need to learn and know all of them to get started. But let's take a step back and look at this a little more closely. If you are looking at game engines first to determine which programming language to choose, go based off their features. Every game engine that is available to the public has a full featured list that is constantly updated to reflect new features introduced with every release. I am going to shut up for a moment and showcase the features in CryEngine, Unity, and Unreal Engine, along with the link to them in the description box. Now that you know the features of each major game development engine and have chosen one, you can now pick the language based off what that engine uses. The two programming languages that are used with these engines are C# and C++. CryEngine and Unreal Engine uses C++. CryEngine and Unity use C#. And before you say, Jesco, how do I start learning? I've got you covered. In the description box below, I will have the links that I have showcased in the video, and we should begin with C++. If you are using Windows, the best IDE or integrated development environment to use is Visual Studio, although there are many more that are decent that I will not go into. macOS and Linux have other IDEs that they use, and I am not familiar enough with them to offer a good suggestion. You should definitely start with reading and following through the basic concepts of C++ listed in the Microsoft documentation, which also has a very nice link to the C++ language reference guide. For further understanding, the C++ ECMA 372 standard is a great place to really gain in-depth knowledge on the language. Following these, you can look at the official ISO C++ standard for C++ 17. Granted, this can be a bit on the pricey side as it is $209.99. Another option is by reading books on C++. The book I recommend is Mastering C++ Programming by Jagannathan Swaminathan. Sorry if I pronounced his name incorrectly. Now let's begin with C#. C# is perhaps my favorite programming language and the one I default to using for most of my projects, unless the task calls for otherwise. Again, Visual Studio is hands down the number one IDE for using C#. If you're on macOS or Linux, then I would suggest Visual Studio Code, as it is a lighter weight version of Visual Studio, but is still very nice. Microsoft has a very nice programming guide and getting started with C# interactive tutorial that is designed with beginners in mind and a very nice language reference on their website. It gives you all of the general programming concepts you would need to get started and to really give you a nice jump start into learning the language. When that well has dried up and you want to sink your teeth deeper into the language, look no further than the standard ECMA 334 C# language specification. It goes deep into the language, which includes every aspect of the language and how it functions. You will learn everything you need to know from there and is a great reference even when you are a seasoned developer. The book I highly recommend for beginning C# is written by Tom Owasiak, called Beginning C# 7 Hands Down, The Core Language. He does a fantastic job at teaching you the core C# language and syntax, along with programming techniques such as object-oriented programming. Studying these resources and practicing everything that you learn will give you all of the knowledge you need to be proficient in C++ or C# programming. The key to remember is to practice. You aren't going to learn just by reading or watching other people write code. It is on you to make sure you write the code yourself and experiment with the knowledge you gain to really facilitate learning. Now let's dive into why you should study the basics in programming before going into any form of specialized development like game development. Game development is comprised of many different parts that can require a specialist. You have graphics programmers, sound programmers, gameplay scripters, level scripters, network programmers, game engine engineers, and physics engine developers. And to be honest, this is just naming a few. Even when using a game engine like Unity, CryEngine, or Unreal Engine, they all use intermediate level programming concepts and really don't hold your hand so much as a beginning programmer. The documentation explains things in a high level detail that more experienced programmers are used to. And it gets worse when you look at example projects or templates. The code is commented or self-documenting, but it is not normally framed with someone who has never dealt with programming before in mind. Once you have become proficient in your programming language of choice, you can then move on to either learning more programming languages or starting to learn to use the game engine you want to use. Then you can follow up this video and check out some of my tutorials on whichever engine and language you have chosen. This has been Jesco the Rising Phoenix Dev, and I'm signing out.